Hello, this is RetroTK2, and today you'll learn about some of the basic operators in C#. You'll get to see all the additive operators and two of the multiplicative operators. A painfully simple tutorial for you today, yes, but an important one nonetheless. As ever, yes, if you haven't already, I'd advise you to download the channel files that accompany this video. The card should be on your screen now. So let's get started. Open Unity and create a basic C# script. As always, Ace, make sure the script has a different name than any other class in your project. Let's have a look at the additive operators. That's the plus and minus ones, Ace. Now, it has to be said, I won't be going into the use of these operators with any other types other than the numeric ones, Ace, since it can get complicated pretty quickly. I will go into far greater detail later on in this series, but for now we'll be using them for basic adding and subtraction. If we use our knowledge from the basic data types video, the card is on your screen now, yes, we know how to declare a literal integer. Here I'm typing out 1 plus 1, a concept that I'm sure you're all too familiar with, yes. Saving, heading back into Unity, grabbing our script and attaching it to a game object, and running our game, prints 2 to the console, because 1 plus 1 equals 2. I know, yes, Einstein would be proud. Actually, he might, since it was quantum mechanics that paved the way for computers, and quantum mechanics was his discovery. Although he himself wasn't a fan of it. Hang on, yes, what am I doing? 1 plus 1 equals 2. Let's leave it at that. Alright. That was easy. But what if we add an int to a float? What then, yes? Save, head back into Unity, and rerun the game. And you'll see 2 as outputted. So it's exactly the same as before. Well, not exactly, yes. Adding an int to a float will output a float. This probably isn't obvious since we're adding an integer float, if we can call it that. It becomes a little more obvious why it would output it as a float if we give it a decimal value as well. Saving, heading back into Unity, and rerunning our game. Now it outputs 2.11. Since an int type can only ever be an integer, the number has become a float type, otherwise the .11 part would be truncated. We'll go into more detail about type conversions a bit later on, yes, but it's good for us to be thinking about them now. We can also add multiple numbers together. Here I'm adding 1 as an int, 1.11 as a float, and 1.11 as a double. Saving, heading back into Unity, and rerunning, will output 3.22000001430512. Now, I'm no mathematician, yes? Well, actually, that could be debated. However, the result of 1 plus 1.11 plus 1.11 cannot be debated, and should give us 3.22. So why do we have all the other garbage on the end? It's either to do with the number's conversion to a double type, and we know it's a double since it has 15 digits, or it's to do with the advanced inaccuracies of floating point numbers. Either way, yes, it's definitely beyond this tutorial and will be talked about in a much later date. Going back and changing our float to a double, or our double to a float, should give us the desired result. And who said basic mathematics can't be fun? Save, head back into Unity, and rerun the game, yes? And you'll see both are outputted as 3.22. Similarly, the minus operator works in a very similar way. If we copy our positive logs and replace the operators with negative ones, like so, yes? Save, head back into Unity, and rerun our game. You'll see that we get minus 1.22, which is the desired output here, yes. Fairly basic, fairly standard, yes. Let's move on to multiplicative operators, arguably one of the hardest words to say. There are 3 in C#, but we're only concerned with multiply and divide today, yes. The other one will be discussed a little later in this series. Much like the additive operators, the multiplicative can be used in a very similar way. Here I'm going to multiply 2 by 1, and divide 2 by 4. Saving, heading back into Unity, and rerunning our game. We'll give the desired output, 2 and 0.5. What's that, Ace? It's outputting 0 and not the rest? That's because it's being outputted as an int type, Ace, and the 0.5 is being truncated. This is very important to remember, Ace, and we'll no doubt see this type of thing many times when we are programming. We of course will go over this in better detail later on, but for now you can easily solve it by changing one of the numbers to a float type. Save, head back into Unity and rerun the game, and you'll see it output 0.5 as we would expect. Wonderful. Okay, let's move on to something a little more complicated, Ace. Do you remember BODMAS from school? BODMAS is the order of operations in an equation. It stands for B for brackets, O for orders, DM for division and multiplication, left to right, and AS for addition and subtraction, left to right. Here, we're only concerned with DM and AS for now, Ace. Back in Visual Studio, we can create a more complicated equation with our operators. Here, I'm typing out 1F plus 2F minus 3F multiplied by 4F divided by 5F. I made them all floats too, so there's no funny business with truncating this. If we save, head back into Unity and rerun our game, you'll see we get 0.6. Let's break this down, Ace. For the sake of readability, I'm going to do it as a comment, and I'll leave out the F of the floats in my explanation. With BODMAS, we know multiplication and division take priority over addition and subtracting. So here we pass by the plus and minus, and go straight to the multiplication. After that, priority goes from left to right. So here the multiplication sign takes priority over the division sign. Now we just work it out. 3 multiplied by 4 equals 12, giving us the new equation of 1 plus 2 minus 12 divided by 5. Now we know division is done first, Ace, so we'll do 12 divided by 5, which should give us 2.4, giving us a new equation of 1 plus 2 minus 2.4. We then our priority now is left to right, so 1 plus 2 equals 3, giving us the new equation of 3 minus 2.4, and that equated out should give us 0.6. Exactly what is outputted in the Unity console, Ace. Nothing too crazy here, Ace, and now we have a very good understanding of the basic operators in C#. And that's it. Rate, comment, and subscribe, Ace. I hope this episode wasn't too basic for you. You can email me at retrotk2@gmail.com with any of your thoughts. Thank you for watching, Ace, and I'll see you in the next video.